Well, every session we analyzed a quote, and the quote either had a source, or the source could have been the person or a book. But right now in the screen, you find there is no quote. It's a sort of an affirmation and also a statement of fact of every human being. Now, what does it mean? It very simply says, I'm honest, I'm sincere, I'm courageous, I am powerful. Well, here these are statements of fact, which we should be. It's just not an affirmation. Affirmation is you're getting something from outside, but this is our nature, this is our essence. So here we are establishing the statement of fact of these four important traits. I'm honest, I'm sincere, I'm courageous, I'm powerful. Well, let me stop the share screen and then connect with you all. Just keep these four lines, traits in mind. The statement of fact, I'm honest, I'm sincere, I'm courageous, I'm powerful. Well, when I say I'm honest, it's not that I'm trying to prove my honesty to you. The moment I try to prove my honesty, I'm not honest. It's only dishonest people try to establish they're honest, but an honest person does not establish honesty at all. I'm just stating I'm honest. That means that's my state of my being. Because naturally, we people have been created to be honest. We are, in fact, our nature is sat. That means truth. When we live the life of truth, we are honest. And when we are honest, there's no projection, there's no falsification. We live our life totally. That means we don't spend our life energy trying to prove to the world what we are not. We don't spend our life energy trying to project to the world what we are not. Instead, we accept ourselves for whatever we did, the good, the bad, the ugly, everything, the moment we accept, and that is what is an honest state of life. But people who don't accept their lives will try to project to the world what they are not. Now, ego is defined as a compulsive need to project to the world what you're not. So you're very important. Projection and lying and falsifying is not human trait. The real trait of a human being is that we are honest. And the moment I accept myself, I don't have to spend my life energy trying to falsify or project. For instance, in the crime department, there are lots of tests done on a criminal, okay? Or to try to establish that a person is a criminal or not. And one of the tests is lie detector. That means when the person talks and the person tells a lie, that is a chemical changes that happens in his body, in his brain. And therefore they know what the person is saying is a lie. So it has detected it. But there's nothing called a truth detector because you cannot detect truth because it's a part of our life. So therefore let's keep that in mind that we are honest and that's a trait that we need to live by. And then the next line says, I'm sincere. When I say I'm sincere in my relationships. I'm not here to expect something in return from a relationship. The moment I try to expect something in a relationship, that is known as transactional relationship. There is always a quid pro quo. I've done something and I want you to do something for me. But true relationship is that sincerity in relationship. And the moment you're sincere in relationship, that is what is living a human life. Today, there are people who work very, very hard to accumulate a lot of wealth, a lot of money, so many things they want to accumulate. And therefore, they think that is what is richness. Well, let me tell you, that is richness physically. But whereas the real richness is when you're sincere in a relationship, and that sincerity in a relationship, it's going to earn you more friends. And that relationship is what we call as contribution into the emotional bank account of an individual. So sincerity in relationship is, I say something and I keep up my commitment. I am a person who's a man of words. I am always looking out for the betterment of the other. So a sincere person, the trait is, always works in WIIFO. That means what is in it for the other. But a person who's manipulative always works with the trait of WIIFM, what's in it for me. So therefore, as leaders, we need to be sincere in our relationship. Every time when you meet a person, interact with a person, don't calculate what is that I'm going to get from this person. That is transactional. That is not living human life. So therefore, when I say I'm honest, I accept myself and I'm living my life in its natural state. When I say I'm sincere, I'm establishing sincere relationship, expecting nothing in this relationship, but to give everything in a relationship. So here we have found out these two states. One is I'm honest, I'm sincere. And the third state is I am courageous. Now here I'm courageous to stand for my conviction. I have got no fear, no favor, because I'm courageous. Just imagine a situation when you're honest. There's no projection and falsifying. When you're sincere in a relationship, there's no manipulation. Obviously, you have a clarity of life. And that clarity is what is confidence. And that clarity is what is called courage. So therefore, courage is not blindness. Courage is not about getting high on certain things and you go about courageously. But courage is courage only when you have the clarity of what you're doing. So therefore, when you have such a clarity, you'll have no fear at all. Because there are two kinds of people living on this planet. One group of people are the ones who value their lives more than their values. That means they do anything to safeguard their life. But there's a small group of people, the leaders, who value their values much more than their life. So when we say you value your value, it means you hold on to some traits where it adds value to your life, which enhances the quality of your life. And the values are honesty and sincerity. So here we have found out being courageous is a trait, and that courage is only due to clarity. Without clarity, if you're courageous, very shortly, you're going to hit a dead end at no point in time, and probably you will meet the eventuality. So therefore, let's have clarity in life. Let's have the purpose in life, and that is what is courageous. And then it says, I am powerful. I'm honest in my relationship with myself. I'm sincere in my relationship with other. Now I've got the clarity of life and I'm courageous. And now I am powerful. I'm powerful, so powerful that the power that must come from outside. For many people, power comes from money. For many people, power comes from the barrel of the gun. For many people, power comes because they're connected to powerful people. All these are transient, transitionary power. But the real power is the power that comes from within. So when you're very powerful from within, you use the power to empower people. But the power that you get from your money and the barrel of the gun is only to exploit people. So empowering people is what is the task of a leader, an important trait of a leader. So when you say you're a leader, I am powerful to empower. That means first and foremost, you must have the power from within to empower people. If you don't have the power, you cannot empower at all. So therefore, let's work for power, not to accumulate power from outside, but let's live our life so that we can generate power from within. Because we are a piece of creation. And this piece of creation has got the power to become a creator. So therefore, let's tap into ourselves and become so powerful that we can empower people. Because in the sessions, I did tell you, one of the traits of a leader is the power to empower people. And now having this power, go about empowering people. When you are such a person, when a person picks up the phone and talks to you, feels empowered. The very thought of you gets the person empowered. That is what is living a powerful state of human life. So here, these are the four important traits that you need to adhere and internalize, because that is naturally ours. It's all about an awareness. And the moment we live with awareness, we reclaim our talent, our latent talent, and work on it. So here, you reclaim that aspect of yours that is, I'm honest, I'm sincere, I'm courageous, I'm powerful. And now you can say, I am a Miltonian. So therefore, let me tell you, for some people, you might say, good riddance, the program is over and I'm off. If you consider so, you're right, because you consider MILT as a course. And if you consider MILT as a course, your course gets over tonight in a couple of hours. But if you consider MILT as a powerful way of life, then you live by these traits. And therefore, MILT is not merely a course. We sold it to you as a course, basically to introduce to you the important essential aspects that you need to train in and live by. So therefore, we trained you on these dimensions. So therefore, MILT is not merely a course. MILT is a powerful, empowering way of life. That's why we say every Miltonian is a very, very powerful person. When Aporesh Acharya started this initiative of training, Aporesh created a training revolution in this country way back in the year 1977 when he started training programs in India. Well, when he started the program, he had a dream, and the dream was big. The vision that he had is, let this world be a little better because I came over here. And with that determination and dedication, for close to four decades, Aporesh went about empowering people. And today this platform is there, and I've been trained by Aporesh Acharya, and I'm taking on the baton from him and conducting these programs with the essence of MILT, not to help you to manipulate the society further with your communication skills, not to manipulate the society further by using the human relation principles, but we want you to empower people with your communication skills, empower people with their human relation skills, and then you can proudly say, I'm honest, I'm sincere, I'm courageous, I'm powerful, I am a Miltonian. So the moment you say I'm a Miltonian, it signifies these qualities. And if you don't have it, even if you have a MILT certificate, you're not a Miltonian at all. So therefore, let's keep this in mind that we need to hold on to that essential state of our life. The lofty state of human life is these traits. And let's live life to the hilt without any guilt. Let's live a life which is aligned. Let's live a life which is integrated. Let's live a life that is consciousness, where you're absolutely conscious with whatever you're doing. And that is a very, very powerful state of human life. So therefore, this program gave you the template, gave you the inputs, trained you in 4 weeks' time to experience it. And now that you got these inputs, it is with you to make the best use of it and evolve. And I'm sure you people have committed yourself for all these days and did the program, and I'm sure that you're going to live a life of a leader.